What is happening, everyone? Hope you're having a great day. Welcome to the last episode of Beach Pod Mania 2017. So to say, the season finale of this current series. Now, before I go into this episode, I just want to say thank you to everybody who was commenting, asking me questions, and just watching these videos throughout the series. I'm grateful for all your support, and I just want to say thank you. Now, going into the series, since this entire series was dedicated to fat loss and cutting, I will show you the progress that I made over the past 9.5 weeks or 66 days, whichever you like to count it. But before I do that, I just want to explain why I'm using such a weird benchmark, like 9.5 weeks or 66 days. Why not 10 weeks or 9 weeks? The reason is I got contacted to do a photo shoot today, which is on July the 5th, so the 66th day of my cut. So I decided it would be a nice way to kind of just benchmark the progress and use that as a finale for this series, something kind of interesting and something that can actually truly show off how the coaching progress went on and how, like, what I achieved. So that's the reason why. Now, going back to the coaching, so what I'm gonna do now is compare my first chicken and my last chicken, so from chicken from today, two videos. So in my first chicken, I weighed in at 89.7 kg and I was pretty fluffy. I was about 14% body fat, I'm guessing. And then in today's video, you can see I'm much more leaner. I weighed in at 81.8 kg. So it's an overall 7.9 kg drop or 17.5 pound drop in 66 days, of which I'm very happy. So, like, you can see there's much more definition on me in today's video. Like, I'm much more leaner, and I'm just very happy with how the cut went. I'm not gonna lie, like, but what I just wanna say about this, it's, although I'm lean and all, I'm not competition lean, and if I was to compete, I would probably have to cut for another 5 or 6 more weeks and lose another 4 kg or so, if not more. And what the reason I'm not going like super shredded, super crazy shredded, is because after certain kind of body fat percentages, after like cutting for a certain time and going into kind of low body fat percentages, you begin to do more detriment to your health than benefit from being lean, if that makes sense. And like, going into the last weeks of competition prep, not always healthy, because you will be in a very low calories and you will be like, you won't be feeling as well and you won't be functioning as well. And there, I didn't see the point of doing all those things just to look slightly leaner on beach or on a photo. So, like, I'm extremely happy with where I am at now, and I'm just gonna maintain that and keep that body composition until the end of the summer before I go back on lean bulk in September. So I just want to say that. And in terms of the entire cutting, what I just want to highlight is that there is no huge secret to weight loss. What it is, it's just patience and being kind of dedicated. Like, there was no huge secret to my training. My training remained the same as I used during my lean bulk. So the training program that I use is in the description box below. You can just download it and use it, it's free. And then in terms of nutrition, it's all described in the videos that I did at the start of this series. I'm gonna link them down also in the description so you can watch them and see what I did for training and nutrition. But there was no huge secret. It's pretty much training remained the same, nutrition, it more or less remained the same. It just was less calories than I was in a bulk, but you have to be in a calorie deficit to lose fat. And that's the way it works. You cannot lose fat when you're in a caloric surplus. And that's kind of pretty much basics. And I'm pretty sure you know it, but just want to highlight it. So those things. And in terms of cardio just went up slightly just to ensure I was in a caloric deficit, because as you spend more time in a caloric deficit, as you spend more time cutting, your metabolic rate adjusts and you have to either drop more calories to maintain the caloric deficit or increase your caloric output, so like do more exercise or do both things to ensure the cut. And the way it was for me, I started off at 3000 calories at the start of my cut, and towards the end of the cut, so the week 10, I am at 2400 calories. And in terms of cardio, I started off at doing 1 or 2 cardio sessions a week, and then I increased it until, like, right now what I'm doing was 4 or 5 cardio sessions a week. And those cardio sessions are where either in the morning, so fasted cardio, or after training session, so like pseudo fasted state. So there was no huge secret about it. It's what you put in is what you get out. Like, there is, If you do those things, if you monitor your nutrition, you do your training properly, you will see a result. And same goes not just for fat loss, but for muscle gain when you're bulking. So I just want to say those things. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this series. Right now, with that footage, let's go into the photo shoot, because it's time to get ready and head up to the photo studio to put on some Zoolander mojo on, put a few Zoolander faces, and enjoy it. So let's go. Now, I just realized I haven't fully explained where this photo shoot suddenly came out of. So pretty much what happened a few weeks back, a photo studio in Berlin messaged me on Instagram and asked me would I like to be like photographed, because they saw my Instagram account and they liked what I saw. Zoolander mojo.
Wow, you're ridiculously good looking.
And pretty much I said, why not? Let's do this. And that's why we are here today, to get some photo shoot done. So we're just over here. Let's go in.
How you doing?
Hi.
Nah.
Nice to meet you.
Hey, nice to meet you. Where are you from?
Ireland.
Yeah, just a glass.
Thank you.
So here we are doing the photo shoot. We're in the first location of this photo shoot. And as you can see, there's a kind of cool background of a very long haul. And I'll show you kind of how this photo shoot turns out in a bit with a few of the photos. But for right now, let's get the Zoolander face on. Let's get it started. I'm out here looking for you. I know I fucked up and that's a fact. I was just trying to do me, trying to succeed with this music, I know. So currently in the middle of a photo shoot, photos are taken of me with a camera, in the camera.
Can you, like when the light comes from there, like kind of just, yeah, okay.
So this is as inception as it gets. Zoolander. Have you seen Zoolander, no?
Huh?
Have you ever seen the movie called
Zoolander? Yeah.
Like whenever I do any photo shoot or anything fashion related, it's Zoolander.
Blue steel.
What's that look like?
So we're back in the studio about to do more photo shooting, more photos, more Zoolander stuff, and I'm about to utilize the most important thing you can do for a photo shoot to get that pump, get those veins going, and that is a Snickers bar. Placement, not paid for, but what the Snickers bar does is fast release carbohydrates, fats, and some protein, and allow you to maintain that pump for a prolonged period of time. So let's get this into myself and let's get more Zoolander faces on. I spend too much time in the studio. I
know you don't support that shit, but I need you in my life. For all time fitness or?
I was always sporty, so like I played sports all my life, but like proper, like this kind of body, maybe in the past, maybe 3 years or so.
3 years.
Okay. So like, cause I.
Is this where you wanna stay?
Or do you also
bear in mind that it needs to be bigger and bigger?
No. So maybe like 3-4 kg more, mm-hmm. but like so like yeah. slightly bigger, like yeah. like nothing like hugely kind of, you know, that's kind of big bodybuilders.
But you don't want to go competition or anything.
Do you know like physique?
Natural
physique. Yeah. So like maybe something like that. So it's I don't like have anything like kind of Mr. Olympia, mm-hmm. kind of those big bodies. Mm-hmm. I don't find them appealing.
No.
But like something like a more natural kind of physique competitors, yeah. yes, maybe. Like,
yeah.
Maybe that
fits you. It's not like looking unnatural or.
Yeah, so like I don't like, as long as it's healthy and it's. Just kind of.
Not exaggerated.
Yeah. It's like I'm doing this more for health and just for kind of because I enjoy like lifting heavy things
right.
more than anything else.
Challenges.
Yeah. I'm looking for you right now. I'm looking for you right now. So here we are, that's the end of the photo shoot. It was my first proper photo shoot experience in a photo studio. I didn't really know what to expect going in, but it was pretty cool. Like I did my best Zoolander expressions, best blue steels, and I put up the photos like throughout the entire photo shoot, throughout the entire video so you can see them. which you probably have seen at this stage because this is the ending of this video. So what I want to say before I finish up this video is huge thank you for watching this video, and if you enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up. And as well as a huge thank you for watching the entire video throughout the entire series. I greatly appreciate it. The Beachbot Mania series will be coming back again probably around next summer when the Beachbot Mania strikes people and people want to get the Beachbot. And until then, I'll be doing more vlogs, more videos, as per usual. I'm not going away. You're not getting rid of me that easy. So until next video, stay strong. Papa. I'm looking for you right now.